phone without a carrier. Is that actually possible? What's up guys, I'm Snoza and this is your boot sequence. So, a smartphone company claims that it can deliver phone service to everyone without actually having a carrier. That company is called Volk Fi, and it's actually a pretty interesting concept. So this is how it works. You buy their phone called the Volk One, which is pretty much a regular flagship Android phone with your choice of Snapdragon 845 or 855. And they come equipped with a long-range RF transmitter. With traditional carriers, your phone will be connected to the nearest cell tower, and that's where you get your service. With Volk Fi though, your phone will actually connect to other Volk phones to create the network. Now you're probably gonna ask, well, how am I gonna have access to the internet or to phone services? Well, it's pretty simple. If you're connected to Wi-Fi, you have access to the internet. And if someone in the area needs internet, the signal will bounce through your phone so they could have access to it too. The phones also come with a sort of router that connects to your home network and has the same long-range RF chips inside of them. That way, you or someone else could connect to the internet using it. Basically, this is a mesh network like what you would find in your home if you have Wi-Fi pods. To make this happen though, a lot of phones are gonna need to be in circulation. Not only that, but the internet speeds is also going to be limited to whoever has the fastest connection. Range will also be something of a concern since plenty of areas outside of cities won't have a connection. Now I do think this is a great idea, but it can't replace a regular carrier, and that's why this phone will still sport a SIM card slot. Oh, and it has a notch. At least they're already doing some testing in Hawaii and it seems like it's working out. But here is my prediction. This company will make one phone, which is apparently going to ship in December, and then a large telecom or another phone manufacturer or maybe a huge tech giant will just swoop in, buy the company, and maybe we'll see the technology integrated into a new phone, or maybe we'll never hear from the Volk Fi network again. I'm betting on the latter though. There are other concerns that I haven't discussed here, like security or what happens if someone uses too much data, but I want to know what you guys think about this. Good? Bad? Meh? As always, if you want to dig deeper, the link is always down below. Next up, over the weekend you might have seen images floating around on a controller made by Google. Well, this image comes from a patent Google filed in October last year and it was just published at the end of January this year. This patent though, it isn't even for the controller. It's actually for a push notification system that would go from the console to the controller, or actually from any device to the controller. For example, let's say a new game is out or you get a friend invite, you just set up a new high score or something like that, well, those notifications would show up on the controller. The patent filing did have a controller portrayed on it though, but it was merely just an example. Twitter user RepsUp100 made a 3D render out of it, and that's when everybody went crazy. I mean, personally, I've never been a fan of controllers where both joysticks are at the bottom, but this one just looks uncomfortable, a little bit like the Ouya controller and the Wii Classic Controller Pro, which I absolutely hate. Anyways, Google's GDC event is next week, so if Project Yeti comes to fruition and we do get a console and this controller from it, I'll make sure to keep you guys informed. Then in gaming, sort of, the trailer for the next Doom movie has just come out. It's called Doom Annihilation and the trailer is so bad that the official Doom Twitter needed to clarify that it had nothing to do with the movie. You should really watch it for the giggles. After this horror show, the 2005 Doom movie is going to be called the Good Doom Movie. And also in gaming, it looks like Apex Legends is getting data mined to hell. Apparently in one of the upcoming updates, we should expect a nighttime mode, a hover bike, some wall running, and some NPCs that could take the place of missing teammates or something like that. Now of course, the most plausible out of all of these is the nighttime mode and the possible vehicle. I'm not saying the rest is impossible, but this game is basically a hard mod of Titanfall, which means that there is a high likelihood that some of the code from the original games are still inside of Apex Legends. Anyways guys, that is pretty much it for the news. Hopefully you've enjoyed. As usual, don't forget to leave a comment down below. Let me know what you guys thought of today's stories. You can click right here to see the latest video, right here to subscribe to the channel. It would be greatly appreciated. As always, stay frosty, and I'll see you guys on the next one.